With this, we are going to begin with our next topic, Domain Keys Identified Mail, DKIM. Is a specification for cryptographically signing email messages, permitting a single domain to claim responsibility for a message in the mail stream, message recipient, or the agent acting in their behalf can verify the signature by querying the signature's domain directly to retrieve the appropriate public key and thereby can confirm that the message was attested to by a party in possession of the private key for the signing domain. DKIM is a proposed internet standard, RFC 4871. Domain Keys Identified Mail, DKIM signatures. DKIM has been widely adopted by a range of email providers, including corporations, government agencies, Gmail, Yahoo, and many internet service providers. The Internet Mail Architecture. To understand the operation of DKIM, it is useful to have basic grasp of the Internet Mail Architecture, which is currently defined in RFC 5598. This subsection provides an overview of the basic concepts. At its most fundamental level, the Internet Mail Architecture consists of a world in the form of Message User Agents, MUA, and the Transfer World in the form of the Message Handling Service, MHS, which is composed of Message Transfer Agents, MTA. The MHS accepts a message from one user and delivers it to the one or more other users, creating a virtual MUA to MUA exchange environment. This architecture involves three types of interoperability. One is directly between the users. Messages must be formatted by MUA on behalf of the message author, so that the message can be displayed to the message recipient by the destination MUA. There are also interoperability requirements between MUA and the MHS. First, when a message is posted from an MUA to MHS, and later when it is delivered from the MHS to the destination MUA. Interoperability is required among the MTA components along with the transfer path through the MHS. The figure here illustrates the key components of the Internet Mail Architecture, which include the following: Message User Agent, MUA, operates on behalf of user actors and user applications. It is their representative within the email service. Typically, this function is housed in the user's computer and is referred to as a client email program or a local network email server. The author MUA formats a message and performs initial submission into the MHS over a MSA. The recipient MUA processes received mail for storage and or display to the recipient user. The mail submission agent, MSA, accepts the message submitted by an MUA and enforces the policies of loading the domain and the requirements of the internet standards. This function may be located together with the MUA or as a separate functional model. In the latter case, the simple mail transfer protocol, SMTP, is used between MUA and MSA. Message Transfer Agent, MTA, relays the mail from one application level hop, It is like a packet switch or IP router in that its job is to make the routing assessments and to move the message closer to the recipients. Relaying is performed by a sequence of MTAs until the message reaches a destination MDA. An MTA also adds the trace information to the message header. SMTP is used between MTAs and between MTA and an MSA or MDA. The Mail Delivery Agent MDA. This is responsible for transferring the message from the MHS to the MS. Message Store MS. An MUA can employ a long-term MS. An MS can be located on a remote server or on the same machine as the MUA. Typically, an MUA retrieves messages from a remote server using POP, Post Office Protocol, or IMAP, Internet Message Access Protocol. Two other concepts need to be defined. An administrative management domain, ADMD, is an internet email provider. Examples include a department that operates a local mail, relay, MPA, an IT department that operates an enterprise mail relay, an ISP that operates public shared email service. Each ADMD can have different operating policies and trust-based decision-making. One obvious example is the distinction between mail that is exchanged within an organization and mail that is exchanged between independent organizations. The rules for handling the two types of traffic tend to be quite different. The domain name system, DNS, is a directory lookup service that provides a mapping between the name of the host on the internet and its numerical address. Email threats, RFC 4684. Analysis of threats motivating domain keys identified mail describes the threats being addressed by DKIM in terms of characteristics, capabilities, and location of potential attackers. Characterized on three levels of threat. At the low end are attackers who simply want to send email that a recipient does not want to receive. The next level are professional senders of bulk spam mail and often operate as commercial enterprises and send messages on behalf of third parties. And the last one, the most sophisticated and financially motivated senders of messages are those who stand to receive substantial financial benefit, such as from an email-based fraud scheme. The capabilities of RFC 4686. Submit messages to MTA and Message Submission Agents, MSAs, at multiple locations in the internet. Construct arbitrary message header fields, including those claiming to be mailing lists, resenders, and other mail agents. Sign messages on behalf of domain under their control. Generate substantial number of either unsigned or apparently signed messages that might be used to attempt a denial of service attack. Resend the messages that may have been previously signed by the domain. Transmit messages using any envelope information desired. Act as an authorized submitter for messages from a compromised computer. Manipulation of IP routing This could be used to submit messages from specific IP addresses or difficult to trace addresses, or to cause diversion of messages to a specific domain. Limited influence over portions of DNS using mechanisms such as cache poisoning. This might be used to influence message routing or to falsify advertisements of DNS-based keys or signing practices. Access to significant computing resources, for example, through the conspiration of worm-infected zombie computers. This could allow the bad actor to perform various types of brute force attacks. Ability to eavesdrop on existing traffic, perhaps from a wireless network. The location DKIM focuses primarily on attackers located outside of an administrative unit of the claimed originator and the recipient. These administrative units frequently correspond to the protected portions of the network adjacent to the originator and recipient. It is in the area that the trust relationships required for authenticated message submission do not exist and do not scale adequately to be practical. Conversely, within this administrative unit, there are other mechanisms to say authenticated message submission that are easier to deploy and more likely to be used than DKIM. External bad actors are usually attempting to exploit the any-to-any nature of email that motivates most recipient MTAs to accept messages from anywhere for delivery to their local domain. They may generate messages without signatures, with incorrect signatures, or with correct signatures from domains with little traceability. They may also pose as a mailing list, greeting cards, or other agents that legitimately send or resend messages on behalf of others.